my back is just dead. I threw out my back.
You want to sit back there? I think that's what you're saying. Yes, I want to sit back there.
Like
It's the one that I see. She's
thank you. Please make your way to the nearest exits. No food or drink are allowed in the theater. We ask that you please make sure that your cell phones are on silent or vibrate so that they don't disturb the person next to you when they go off. And I think that's all I was going to say. Enjoy the concert. How many of you recognize that first piece? Hopefully a lot of you. So many of you might know that I was out on medical leave. I broke my back this summer, and so I was out for the entire month of September, and it was not fun sitting in bed watching reruns of Seinfeld. But I had a long-term sub. I had Dr. Cheeseborough from Keene State University, who retired in May, and I called him up over the summer, and I was like, so I know you're retired, and I know you have a lot of free time on your hands. What do you think about coming in and doing a long-term sub gig for me? And he graciously accepted. So a lot of what you hear on stage tonight was started by him. He was here for the entire month of September, so I have to make sure that I give my thanks to Dr. Cheeseborough for helping me out. We've been friends for a very long time. I've known him since I was in high school myself. So I was very grateful that he stepped in and wanted to do that. Our next piece is Grace and Being. I had the absolute pleasure to meet the composer of our next piece, Julie Giroux, at Plymouth State University this past summer at the New England Band Directors Institute. We got to read through some of her new music that she's written, and I even got to sign the score of this piece, which I'm really excited about. From 1985 to 1997, Julie orchestrated for television and films, and now her focus has shifted more towards composing for concert band and orchestras. Her piece, The Grace in Being, was commissioned by the Sagamore School Symphonic Band in Indianapolis, Indiana, in memory of Dr. Donald W. Johnson. Beyond that description, there's no other information available on this piece, but I want to share with you the reason that this piece was written that she told us this summer. Dr. Johnson was a neurosurgeon and was also a member of the military. The piece starts with a rhythm that you will hear through the entire piece. At the end of the piece, it has a distinct rhythmic shift, and this rhythmic shift is a symbolic of Dr. Johnson's choice to come out as he was on his deathbed. Grace and Being is a musical journey of a soul unable to be what he was meant to be. So I know this is a winter concert, and I always try to choose pieces that are kind of fitting into the theme of the winter concert. So Into the Storm. Whenever I program this, we always happen to have a snow day before the concert. So we've had two this year. That's awesome. So I told all the band members to bring a fun hat. So this is Into the Storm by Robert W. Smith.
Thank you.
So I'm going to try something new with this year's concert. There's something that's not in your program. And the reason is because you guys get the privilege of, you get to hear the final product of everything that we do, all our hard work from September through October, all the way through November. You get to see the final product. And sometimes the final product is, you know, there's nerves on stage and there's other factors going in. So sometimes what was good in a rehearsal, like maybe last week, was probably their best performance versus tonight. What you don't ever get to hear is the sight reading and what happens on the first day of rehearsal when everyone comes in and they're trying to figure out how to hold their instruments again after summer break, what their notes are, what their fingerings are, how they put their instrument together. And so I saw this at a workshop, I think over when I went to Chicago, and the concept is that they do sight reading on stage, which is what we're gonna do for you right now. They've never seen this piece before. They've maybe probably never heard it, unless they remember the high school playing it like 6 years ago when they were in middle school. But the idea is that I'm gonna show you what it sounds like if you were to walk into my classroom on the very first day, and then we're gonna present this piece for you again, finished and polished at the Monster Band concert, so you can see the progress from what it sounds like on day one to all the way at the end. So bear with us, because there's probably gonna be some mistakes, and I told the kids that's fine, because part of learning is learning how to fail. You don't learn unless you fail. Fail stands for first attempt in learning, and it's okay if they fail. So, you know, if I'm shouting out numbers and stuff like that, that's typical of what happens in my rehearsal. So anyways, this is Prelude and Fugue in B-flat major by John Sebastian Bach.
Thank you.
first reading. We never actually get all the way through it. So they did a really good job. So please give them another round of applause. And you'll hear the final product of that at our Monster Band concert and also when we take it to competition. So I've learned over the years that if I write my notes, I get really like stage fright, and then if I don't write my notes, then I forget what I'm going to say. So just off the top of my head, thank you to Scott Payne back there, who's doing lights and sound for us and did programs. All of these lovely decorations that you see was the responsibility of Matt Madonna, who stayed after school after finals today, and I kid you not, I did every little thing that you see in this auditorium and out there. So based on the movie. In fact, Dr. Cheeseburger asked me, he's like, did you pick this based on the movie? I'm like, no, I just picked it because it had a catchy title. So this is our closer, this is Venom, and then after we finish, we're gonna strike the stage, do a picture, and then you can stick around for the choir, which I hope you do. So this is Venom.
I Oh.
very much. That piece, in Latin, says, where charity and love are, God is there. The gist of it, anyway. I won't go through the whole translation, but a very difficult piece with not only a cappella, but with dissonances, close harmonies that were really difficult to learn. And both the band and the choir are a little bit at a disadvantage because we have our morning band and choir kids who only get to come a little bit, a couple days, 20 minutes, half an hour tops, and they have a class during choir. But they put in the extra time to be able to perform with us. So both the band and choir have members here who are really performing with the full group, possibly for the first time. So that was a piece that we've already talked about, possibly bringing that to competition in May, polishing it a little more even than for tonight, and really being able to do the piece justice at competition. So we're going to kind of explore that a little bit, and maybe not hear it in the concert again, but if you hear any kind of recording from the competition, you may hear it again from there. So a little kind of aside about the decorations. I joked with Matthew because Matthew is only in morning choir, and so he doesn't get a grade for the class. I was like, I can't even give you extra credit for this. It's like, I wasn't going to go all out, and he wanted to and did, so it was pretty amazing. So thank you, Matthew. Our next piece is going to feature one of our seniors. The fact that she's a senior is just a bonus, but she speaks fluent German, and we're singing in German. So my apologies to both her and to anyone out there who does speak German. We did our best with the pronunciation, but she's been great and hasn't given us at all a hard time about it. So we decided, though, that because she did speak fluently, that it would be really beautiful to have her start the song. So this will open up with Erika Moser, the Snow Carol, or Schnee. Thank you. Pentatonics, we are not, but we're gonna try. A really cool song that I didn't actually know, and is this Kanye West, right? Kanye West. But Pentatonix did a version of this song called Coldest Winter, and we are going to make our best attempt. Pentatonix has a really low bass, So we had to adjust some notes and it made it really challenging, but you guys pulled it off. Thanks. Next up will be our real holiday tune. It's kind of a different version of Deck the Hall, as you can see in the program with all that and all that jazz. Just got a little kind of a jazz waltz feel to parts of it, and then a march to parts of it. It's kind of different. So here's Deck the Hall. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Well, fun. We'd like to close out. Let's see, I'm sure there's some announcements I'm supposed to make. I, too, don't have notes, so off the top of my head. You've received information about our trip, and I know some of you have questions about fundraising, you know, if kids have money in fundraising, and if we're doing any more, we'll answer all that. We just got to get through, like, this and grades and everything, and we'll be in touch about that. But the deadline is December 11th to sign up. Good news this year is you can do it on a credit card and don't have to have that cash or check in hand right out of your account. So that hopefully will help some of you, and we will certainly try to find fundraising opportunities for the kids to help out. And I will let you know how much money some of them have in their account presently. Let's see what else. We've got lots going on. This Saturday, we've got kids performing in the New England Soul and Ensemble Music Festival. And if they get good enough scores, we're not supposed to call an audition, but if they do score well enough, they get selected for the New England Music Festival in March, which is a three-day festival, so that's kind of exciting. We have caroling next week, and I'm hoping that a lot of these people might join me Tuesday night for the senior dinner, the Rotary dinner at the community center. We perform for them. And then next Saturday, and any of you are welcome to join us, a week from this Saturday on December 8th, is the Candlelight Stroll. I know you know about it, but we carol down the street, down from the schools to the village, and it's a wonderful event. And I would encourage any parents out there to come join us. Bring a headlamp, because I'll have carol books for you, but you won't be able to see them if you don't have light. So I don't know what else. Thanks to the Pops for all they do for us all year long, and they've been hard at work preparing for the craft fair on Saturday with their raffle baskets. So please visit them. I think they're usually right in this area, actually. Visit them at the craft fair on Saturday and buy a raffle ticket for one or several of their wonderful baskets they put together and everything else they do throughout the year. So thank you to the Pops. Thank you to all of you. And anything else I've forgotten? Lots of important things, but anyway, here we go. Our final selection will actually be performed in the Granite State Music Festival in January. We were asked this year to each teacher going to select one of the songs to learn and learn it so that every school knew at least one of the songs when we went, just to help out with the learning process. So this is a wonderful gospel tune called Shine On Me, and I think it's a great way to end. So we hope the sun shines on you throughout your holiday season, and happy holidays from all of us.